All right, team. So, today is a big day. The title of the video is not a joke. We do have new pets to play with. And it is a new expansion pack with 55 new pets, as well as a weekly pack, which has new pets in it as well. Now, this is the beta, which I'll put the link down below in the video description so that you can try them out too. But this is big. New pets. Let's get started. Let's see what we can do. So everything's different in this pack. So let's see. So already you're seeing different keywords. So tier 1 Peach gives a pet plus 2 health. Iguana, whenever an enemy is summoned or pushed, deal a damage to it, which has synergy with the seahorse. When the seahorse dies, it pushes an enemy. And then a little baby duck. Give rightmost shop pet plus 1 when you sell it, which isn't terrible. Because if you tier something up, that'll always be the rightmost. And honestly, you can buy most of the shop if need be to make sure this hits who you want to hit. So it's not terrible. I mean, the duck wouldn't win you the early game, but it would make it so your mid game is that much better. Mouse, when you sell it, it makes a free apple. It replaces the food and gives you a free apple. That's kind of goofy. Let's go double mouse, why not? And let's be the delicious crisp bananas. Like right after you fry it. This is exciting. New pets. I tried this beta out a couple days ago and it was really rough. It was stuttering and everything. It seems like they did a lot to fix it. So you see the seahorse would have pushed it behind whatever else pets they had, but they were done with their pets. And then the iguana snipes the thing it pushed. Alright, let's see. We are going to... So, the hummingbird at the start of battle, if we had a strawberry friend, would give it +2/+2. A strawberry is its own separate, unique food, which we haven't seen one yet, so we're not going to build into it. Pillbug is interesting, because when the shop tiers up, it gives the two pets behind it +1 health. So because we're on turn 2, about to be turn 3, we're going to buy that pillbug, because it'll give these two +1 health. Going to get another mouse. Brand new stuff. This is pretty crazy. So see, that's what the strawberry looks like. It's just a food. It doesn't do anything except for enable other strawberry abilities. Yeah, they definitely won that one. So I've only played 2 games of this so far, just kind of testing it out and everything. So you see, as we upgraded our shop tier, because we're on turn 3, that gave the two pets behind it +1 health, which is pretty good. So see, there's a strawberry. If we push the strawberry on the seahorse and then play a hummingbird, it would get +2/+2 at the start of the turn. We might go stork here, because stork is actually pretty good. Alright, we're going to combine those, see what we get for a tier up. Donkey, when a friend faints, we push the first enemy all the way to the back. That kind of works with what we're doing with this weird push build we got going on. I want that seahorse as well. We might sell the mouse here, get 2 free apples, which would work well with like food builds, but it doesn't seem, apart from like strawberry and stuff, I haven't seen many food builds in this. Which one are we going to keep is the question. Let's plan on keeping the stork. I kind of like the stork. Let's do something like that, and then we're just going to roll. So lollipop, swap attack and health of a pet, that's big. Another iguana could be big for our build. Stork, definitely. Don't really like the jellyfish. It's whenever a friend levels up, it gets +1/+1. So I don't think it really happens enough. However, I have seen some synergy. There's these weird pets that like give experience in the middle of battle. If you combine the jellyfish with that, it might have potential. as you can see, this game gets kind of crazy now with everything like flipping back and forth. All right, we win that. Not bad. All right, we're on two wins. Dove, when it faints, it gives Strawberry Friend +1/+1, which we might be able to come up with a decent pairing for that. Let's get another iguana. Let's get another stork for sure, and hopefully we get another stork. Okay. So this is what I'm talking about, the pug. When at the start of battle, you give a friend ahead 1 experience, which that does not stay. I know it seems broken at first, but the experience does not stay. It's just in the battle. However, that means you could level something up from level 1 to 2 every single turn, which means that would enable the jellyfish to be good. If you're talking about, like, an octopus, you can make sure it's getting that 8-8 buff every I don't know. There's potential for it. Leech, at the end of the turn, deal 1 damage to the pet ahead and gain 1 life. So that works very well with hurt triggers, like camel, pufferfish, things like that. You just have the leech, well, probably not pufferfish, because it's during your turn, not in the battle. But with camel, it would work very well. Yeah, there's a lot of potential. I'm excited to see how this integrates into the other pets. This is the one thing I'll say, it is absolutely crazy if you think they're not going to nerf, is the panda. Panda is a 2-4 level tier 1 pet that when at the beginning of battle, it basically faints itself and gives half of its stats to the thing in front of it. But once it gets level 2 and 3, it gives 100% and then 150% respectively, which is broken. Absolutely broken. This right here. I'll let you read it really quick. But ultimately, there's no way they don't nerf that before this goes out into, you know, the real world, the real game. End turn, gain +1/+1 for each friendly strawberry pet up to 1. That's not bad, but we are not going strawberry strat. As you can see, the food is pretty crazy. +4 attack, -2 defense, and vice versa. And then there's one that's the opposite. I think it's broccoli, where it's -2/+4 instead. You know what might be good here is if we, what if we just like inverse and then combine them so that we get maximum stats when we combine two. All right, let's get a level 2 stork for sure. All right, we're going to combine those. So see, now, I mean, technically, I think just from giving the fried shrimp to it, we kind of gained some stats there. I should have done it right away so I could remember what we gained, but... All right, so clownfish, when a friend levels up, give it +2/+1. That's not bad. Again, could be combined with the jellyfish, pug, that kind of stuff with the experience gain. Another strawberry strat. The toad is pretty cool. Whenever an enemy is pushed or hurt, you make it weak. So it's a targeted bat, which if you get weakness on their best unit and you take away their item, that's pretty big. Orangutan, give the lowest health pet +1/+2 at the end of the turn, which isn't terrible, but you're always buffing your worst unit with that. So it's kind of, I mean, it would buff the iguana right now, which would be pretty good for us, but I gotta take the toad. It just works with our strat. Alright, and then cucumber is a tier 2 food. Give a pet cucumber, gain 1 health at the end of turn. So the scaling foods... Like, you can pretty much leave your scaling off the table and just use foods to do it. It's kind of crazy. Yeah, this panda. But we just threw it in the back and weakened its best unit. The frog is insane. There we go. I'd honestly kind of be surprised if they didn't nerf the toad as well. Maybe make it 1 time per turn until it levels up to a tier 2. We could level up donkey. I don't really care for the donkey as much. Let's see. Not really anything I'm feeling great about. Starfish, whenever you sell a friend, if it had sell ability, gain +1/+1. Pretty good if you're doing buy-sell mechanics. Jellyfish, we went over. Salamander, buy a friend, if it has start of battle ability, gain +1/+1. Woodpecker. I like the woodpecker a lot. That works very well with hurt mechanics. Like camel. Like Triceratops, which we'll see a little later. Alright, so broccoli is the inverse of the fried shrimp. -2/+4. Lollipop, swap attack and health. I really want to make this woodpecker work. So let's look at what we're doing here. Probably get rid of the donkey. Well, let's freeze the woodpecker, because we still have a lot of money to work with. We're definitely getting that toad. We should probably get a cucumber at some point. We want to start scaling a little bit. Panda. Panda is OP. Capybara. Roll unfrozen pets get +1/+1. So like a reverse, what's that one? Dromedary, kind of. So it's a little more random, which is hard to work with. We'll take the stork. Woodpecker, I want to make you wait, but maybe not yet. Maybe if we find hurt mechanics, we're not going to force it. Right now, we got a push thing going on, which isn't 100%. Like, we're not really focused on it. The iguana is still level 1. That's a big starfish. But it's weakened. Because it's weakened, the iguana's dealing 4 damage to it instead of 1. So iguana, toad, and then the push mechanic is a pretty decent combo. Platypus is interesting. When you sell it, you get a duck and a beaver, so you do have to have 2 spots open. But that being said, that's 3 sell mechanics in 1 if you're running a starfish build, which is kind of insane. Alright, donkey, I mean, I don't think we have a spot for that, but let's do that, in turn give other strawberry pets +1/+1, so it's a scaling mechanic, kind of like a penguin, but instead of 2 and 3 level people, it's whoever has strawberries on it. So there's potential for that. Not really what we're looking for here. Fortune Cookie is crazy. It gives a pet basically a 50% chance to crit and deal double damage. So maybe we can show that and do that. I don't think it would work with its ability. With a snipe ability? Would it? I doubt it. We're going to find out. I'm going to take it off of fast forward just so we can kind of see. We're theory crafting, you know? Like this is in the beta. See, this is where the woodpecker is really good. Triceratops, when it's hurt, gives a random friend +3/+3. Alright, so it didn't crit that time, but we gotta see. Yeah, I don't think it can crit on a snipe. It crit there. You saw, like, the big, flashy, like, a comic book style damage calculator there. Alright, there we go. Now we're seeing some stuff we haven't seen yet. First of all, level 2 toad makes it weak 4 times per turn. Absolutely nuts. Fox is really cool. At the end of the turn, steal a random shop food. Health and attack effects are modified by 2. This could be amazing. The only issue I've noticed with this expansion pack is a lot of the food are things like, you know, grapes. Gain 1 gold at the start of every turn, which is great, but, you know, like a fortune cookie, it would all override each other. Whereas if you start getting fried shrimp and broccoli with this fox, it's insane. Praying Mantis is really cool. At the start of the turn, you destroy adjacent friends and gain +2/+2. So if we can get the stork to level 3 and then play a Praying Mantis next to it to kill it, that'd be pretty cool. Okapi. Roll, gain +1/+1 until end of turn, works 5 times per turn. So it's like a, it doesn't stay. That buff doesn't stay. But that being said, it's kind of cool, because if you roll a lot, you get a lot of value. I really want to make this praying mantis work. Okay. We're going to play that separate right now until I hate the sound that that stork makes. Okay, hawk. Hawk is good. Koala is a very interesting mechanic. Works very well with woodpecker, things like that. Alright. I really want to get the stork to level 3 and then praying mantis it to get a level 3. Like tier 4 or 5 unit. So see, the pug gave the experience so that it leveled up at the start. Oh, got the crit on the... Oh, okay. That's a shame. Alright. Alright, let's see. We've seen all these. The puffin just deals 2 damage for each friendly strawberry pet to an enemy. So Pepper is interesting. It health doesn't go under 1, but it's removed when it takes damage. So you can kind of think of it like coconut armor, except for it'll always leave you at 1 health if it was going to one-shot it. The example I've seen other people use is the Focus Sash. If you're familiar with competitive Pokemon, it's the item where you put it on someone and it can't be one-shotted. So that's exactly what it does, is it prevents you from being one-shotted. I really like the hawk. I'm probably going to throw a hawk in there. Because it deals 7 damage to the opposite enemy. So you could put it in the 4th spot and it'll deal 7 damage to their 4th spot, which is a really cool idea. Swordfish, start a battle, deal 100% attack damage to random enemy and itself. That could pair well with Koala and other things that, you know, the self-damage type of people. It's a really cool idea, because if you buff that, it's sniping for a lot, but it's... I don't know. It's kind of crazy. Alright. Let's go... I'm actually going to freeze frog, freeze that. I kind of want the fortune cookie. We're going to do that. Because I think the frog is going to stick around. Siberian Husky, in turn, give 3 other pets with no food +1/+1. So it's kind of an anti-food scaling mechanic. It's kind of interesting. Okay, so we got a level 3 toad. That's cool. Do we really want to level up our seahorse? I mean, we do have a push mechanic thing going. I think we're going too hard into this push mechanic, though. It's kind of falling off. It seems like an earlier game strat. Alright, so see, he has the pepper. So, lived with 1 health. See, we just weakened their whole team. The toad is awesome. Alright. So, we gotta draw, though. Oh, we don't have a level 3 toad. My math is bad. Alright, so Stew, tier 5, food item. Give 3 random pets +2 health. Alright, we'll put the pepper on someone here. But we don't really have anyone worth putting the pepper on except for the stork, which we plan on killing off with the praying mantis. I don't think I want you, seahorse. I want you to go away. I mean, we can use the toad ability just with the weakness. We'll probably get rid of the iguana soon. We'll throw a pepper now for right now. So see, it's going to live because of the pepper. Weird, they went big level 2 pelg. Alright, that's fair. Okay. Level 2 hawk is pretty sweet. So Spinosaurus, whenever a friend faints, give a random friend +2/+2. That is pretty cool. You know what? Seahorse, I'm sorry, buddy, but you gotta go. Let's do something like... I mean, that works 4 times per turn. Let's do something like that. Let's snipe their second unit. We'll get another Pepper. Now that the Hawk's level 2, I feel better about it staying around, so we'll give that the Pepper. So that deals 14 damage to their second place pet, which is pretty cool. I'm going to unfreeze that Praying Mantis. I was really hoping we'd get the Stork to level 3 for it. Not bad. So you gotta remember there's no chocolate in this pack. So that's interesting. Polar Bear, start of turn, give a random frozen shop pet +3/+3. So if you keep something frozen, it's like a level 3 dromedary just focused on one frozen pet. That's kind of cool. Taco, 3 random pets +2 attack. That's pretty cool. The iguana is the thing I want to next get rid of. That was unfortunate. We might just go stew here. I mean, the food is really good in this pack. I really want to get that level 3 stork. Got the crit. Alright, not bad, not bad. We're up to 6 wins. Let's see, I've already explained all of these ones, so nothing new here. Could do a stew. I really want to find something kind of worthwhile, though, to keep. Anteater, when it faints, you summon 2 level 1 ants. That's kind of cool. Hot dog, 2 random pets, 4 attack. It's kind of nutty. Don't hit the iguana, please. Alright, thank you. Alright, this is interesting. So, Velociraptor, start of battle, give coconut armor to 1 random strawberry friend. So if we had 1 really well-buffed unit right now, we could throw this out there, put a strawberry on it, and make sure it gets coconut armor at the beginning of battle, which is kind of insane. Hammerhead Shark, start of turn, gain 1 gold per level 3 pet. The fact that it's a tier 6, I don't think that's going to see a ton of play. Because, I mean, at the most, if you have 4 level 3s, you're getting 4 extra gold at the beginning of the turn. That's a lot of... I mean, if you rolled into like 3 Hammerhead Sharks, it might be worth it, but ultimately for tier 6, that doesn't seem quite strong enough. We're going to throw a Pepper on the Spinosaurus. Even though it's an 8-8, the fact that it'll most likely be getting some of the buffs from itself, from the friends feigning. Ostrich. This one is like a book. End turn, give +1/+1 to 1 pet behind. Multiply buff with the lowest pet tier in the shop. So essentially, the whole thing behind this is, like, if I bought the dove and the koala so that it was only tier 6s in the shop, it would give +6/+6 to the pet behind it. Which seems kind of insane. The more I just explain that, the more I kind of want to make it work. Alright, we're going to freeze it. Zebra, buy and sell, give a random friend +2/+2. That's pretty good. Taco, 3 random pets +2 attack. Pretty good. So next turn, we're getting rid of the iguana for sure. We can use the buy sell of the zebra. Okay. I mean, honestly, the whole putting weakness on that lion was huge because we just beat a 50-50 with our team. And honestly, our team is not good right now. So the toad is how you counter the really dumb panda stuff you're seeing out there. So keep that in mind. Carrot is a tier 6 food, +1/+1 at the end of every turn. So basically, you have a scaling food. All right. Iguana, you're gone. Let's get the Spinosaurus. Let's try out the ostrich. That was a crazy sound that ostrich just made. And then let's get Carrot. Two random pets +4 health. That is pretty strong. Okay, so hindsight with the ostrich, it seems like you really want to have a slot open to buy, sell, and get the bad tiers out of there. But that's fine. Okay, vulture is insane. Lion's pretty good if it's your highest tier pet, gain 100% attack and health. It's very good if you don't want to get another tier 5 or 6, but ultimately we're working with tier 6s, so 2 tier 6s, so lion's obviously not going to work for us. Vulture is nasty, though. Friend faints, deal 2 damage to a random enemy. So it would work very well with our stork. We got to keep that in mind. Yeah, see, just +1/+1. We might get rid of the ostrich. I didn't really plan that one out effectively. See, everyone's going that lion toad, which is fine, because we honestly counter it pretty well with our toad, but not well enough, unfortunately, because of the vulture. And that's the end of that. All right, let's try that again. It's interesting, you know, because everyone's still trying to learn it. There's a lot of new mechanics. I think I've explained most of them at this point, so now I can kind of just go with it. So kiwi, you sell, give a random strawberry friend +1/+2. We do have a strawberry available, so that could be worth it. Alright, so we'll do that. Get a hummingbird. Let's do that. And let's be the crispified pants. Yeah, see, this panda's got to get nerfed. There's no way they're going to roll that out. That'd be nuts. Our team is actually insane right now. Oh, but it doesn't work with the hummingbird panda. Okay, I gotta figure this out then. So the hummingbird has to be behind the panda. I should have known that. Okay, we can still make this work. Okay. There's our buddy. There's the toad. Alright, so here's what we're going to do. Sell, give the +1/+2. Sell, give the +1/+2. Put a toad in the back to get its effect, and then we'll play a koala. So this, at the start of battle, gives +4/+4 to the panda. And then, you know what? Let's just watch what happens. So that still didn't work. Hummingbird did not give it to the... Okay. So that's how you're going to be. Okay. So I might have to play a strawberry on the koala then. Which is not what I wanted to do, but... Alright. I like the strawberry only being on one pet because you can focus fire on that. Alright, so you see this yak. So Pug's interesting. Start a turn, start a battle, give friend who had one experience. Again, I'm not going to trust that it gives it to the panda, so I'm not going to go with it right now. The yak, however, end turn, deal 2 damage to itself, repeat 1 time. I know that seems like it's terrible, but that'll buff our koala, so we're going to go with it. And we'll throw a cucumber on... We're going to keep the toad longer than the hummingbird, in all honesty, so we'll start buffing the health on the toad. So it just dealt 2 damage to itself. Koala gets +1/+1 permanently. So we just need to plan. Yak's going to be gone in 2 turns. I mean, we could sell it next turn, at, well, 2 turns from now, so that we still get the 1 gold back after we get the +2/+2 value. Not bad. I do really like the stork, but we never got it all the way up last time. Alright, let's see. Let's do that. Guinea pig. Buy you summon a, you get a 1/1 guinea piglet, so if you have 2 slots, you basically get 2 pets, which is pretty good for, you know, buy mechanics and stuff like that, buy sell mechanics. Let's see. Okay, that's what we like to see. Donkey, not really feeling that. Woodpecker. Alright, we're going to try a hurt build. We got the koala going. Okay. It was a close one. Wow. Okay. Alright. Hummingbird. You're gone. Alright, blobfish, when it faints, give friend behind 1 experience. Praying mantis, start of turn, destroy adjacent friends, gain +2/+2. So I was thinking of this trying to kill my stork last game, but let's kill the blobfish to give the praying mantis experience. That's interesting. So this turn we are going to be down 1 because our yak is going to die. We could have put a peach on it to keep it alive. That would have been pretty good. But we're just kind of getting our koala statted up a little bit. We really need our panda to get to level 2. These ants are gonna kill us. Unfortunate. Yeah, that's fine. Hamster, roll, gain 1 gold. Interesting. Let's put the woodpecker up front. Instead of activating the koala in the middle of the match, we'll activate the toad on the first two pets we fight. That'd be interesting. But now I'm kind of stuck, because I wanted room for these two. But we don't have it. Interesting shop. Not really what I'm looking for. Not really what I'm looking for so much. That is not bad. We'll combine those next turn. We are on lethal though, so we'll probably lose here, unfortunately. I think this one all came down to not getting the panda to level 2. Alright, so we're gonna weaken that though, which is pretty big. It's unfortunate. Okay. So if you don't know what the cockroach does, start a turn set attack to 1. It's kind of goofy. It prevents you from buffing its attack, essentially. But it could be good for the fact that it's a tier 1 pet. I mean, swapping attack and health with something might be worth it. Alright, let's be the comedic scouts. Fishes. Bumbling fishes. It's even better. Panda into a pill bug, that's a rough. I mean, if that's your shop, that's your shop, you know? We've all been there. Alright, one win. Iguana does work with our... But we're not going to work very... We're not going to put all our eggs into the push basket. Okay, kind of interesting. Next turn we'll have a tier up, which is good. Okay, Iguana did some serious work there. So jellyfish is whenever a friend levels up, gain +1/+1. Well, we are about to level up this friend. Okay. Starfish friend sold, sell ability +1/+1. That is not terrible. Get a stork for right now. About that, we win because of the Stark. Not bad. Alright, I'm glad I chose the Stark because we're leveling it up. Which is going to give our jellyfish the bonus. Friend levels up. Could we do a level up build? This is weird. All right. This is really weird, but you know what? We're going to try it out. We're going to try a level up build. We've kind of just been floating through the builds. First one we did a push. Second one we did What do we even do the second one? Hurt build? Well, we attempted to. We never got a Triceratops or anything like that. That's a shame. But we're just trying out the new mechanics, theory crafting, you know? Gotta expect to lose someone doing that. Alright, so let's level up the jellyfish. What you got? +2/+1 from the clownfish. Hamster gain 1 gold when you roll. That's pretty good. Okay. I want to see another panda, because that'll be another level up. We just really want to try this level up mechanic. That's a shame. All right. All right. This is kind of goofy. We gotta get rid of that seahorse. That's not doing anything for us. Okay. There we go. Okay, so we're gonna level up this, which should give +2/+2 to that. Cool. I mean, we should get this, because it gives... We don't have any pets with food, which is kind of dumb right now, but... So it'd give 3 other pets +1/+1. So that's decent scaling. Let's get rid of that seahorse. That's not doing anything for us. We'll get that. So now we have a little scaling. We have jellyfish and clownfish working together to give our pets scaling when they level up. And then we also have this husky giving +1/+1 to 3 pets at the end. That toad might kill us off here. But nope, we're going to win. All right, 4 wins. Double leech. Wish those came up when I was trying out the hurt build. So blobfish is interesting. Give friend behind 1 experience when it faints. So we could put it right in front of the stork. Vulture is amazing. But I think we're going to try out the strat that we're doing here. Okay, I was thinking blobfish, but honestly, we just rolled into what we would probably give the buffs to. Okay, so let's do that, level it up. So that gets +2/+2, that gets +4/+2. Okay. That panda either needs to level or get out of here. Can't believe we can't level this panda to level 2. That's a big koala. The stork is really good. Because it doesn't scale in the traditional sense, but the fact that it always summons a pet 1 tier behind from where you're at, it scales as the shop tiers scale. So now that we just went to tier 5 pets, will get a tier 4 from this instead of a tier 3. It's very interesting. Alright, this panda's got to go. I could put a pug behind it to level up the jellyfish, which would trigger the clownfish. I don't think it's enough of a buff to really warrant that, though. Oh, I passed up a clownfish. That's so sad. Damn. Alright. That's really sad. $35.39. Okay. So we're stuck at 5 wins for the moment. Lion doesn't really work for us. We'll definitely get the jellyfish up to level 3. All right, let's see. Let's play that this turn. Next turn, we'll do Strawberry Velociraptor. Get rid of this panda, finally. I mean, do we really want the Siberian Husky? That's the question here. It's good, but it's not good enough. We're going to do that. Okay. I cannot believe I've hung on to this panda this long. Oh, wow. This might be bad. They went full vulture with double anteater. The number of snipes. They might actually win. They did! Nope. Oh, they did. That was crazy. And those were all level 1s. 2 anteaters, 2 vultures. That's all you need. That's crazy. Alright. We're going to give coconut armor to the jellyfish. I mean, we would actually get, what, 3 gold because of the hammerhead, but no, not really worth it. This is what I wanted to combine with the woodpecker last game, because if it sniped it twice because we had a level 2, it'd give a +6/+6, and not bad. All right, fortune cookie, definitely want that. In turn, give other strawberry pets +1/+1. That could work for us. Way better than the panda. Why do I still have the panda team? That is the question. I mean, the panda just gets so broken once you get it to level 2, but for some reason that's been the hardest feat in this game. Yeah, coconut armor. That was huge. Alright, everyone in their vultures. Yeah, that's right. Haha, I got my own vulture. Alright. 6 wins. Orca. Summon 2 random level 1 pets with faint abilities. That is pretty good. Okay. So let's get rid of this panda finally. We're going a little crazy on this one. Let's put a fortune cookie on the stork. Zebra by self 2/2. Popcorn, pretty good to put on our tier 6 unit because you get a random tier 6 after it faints. Stegosaurus is amazing if our game goes on for a long time, because it gives a +1/+1 for each turn, so it'd give +12/+12 until end of battle, though it's temporary. Has a big jellyfish in the back. Yeah, that jellyfish wiped us out. Alright, so that was just us today trying to learn the new pets, seeing how they interact with each other, test a couple of the different things. Kind of tested, what, hurt build, level up build. And yeah, it's interesting. There's a lot of new pets. I didn't really get to show off how insane the panda is, because I never got it to level 2 for some reason. Seemed like the hardest feat ever. But yeah, hurt build does get really good. Just did not when I played it today, because I didn't really get what I needed. But yeah, we'll definitely do more videos with the new pets. There's a lot of potential in here. I'm excited to see them roll out. But I'm kind of hoping they do nerf the panda a little bit, because as soon as it gets to level 2, things change. I'll try to show it in the next video. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll catch you all next time. Bye!